We join together with the opening hymn, number 727 on Eagle's Wings. We gather here to give thanks to God for Nellie, to seek God's comfort and His mercy, to give thanks and rejoice the precious gift of eternal life, the resurrection, that Jesus Christ has won for each and every one of us. There's a few announcements before our opening. Since it is cold outside, the committal prayer service will take place towards the end of the worship service, right before the Lord's Prayer. And at the conclusion of the service, the family and the casket bearers will go out to the cemetery for a brief prayer. Number two, the family has provided a luncheon after the service, and the family requests that you begin the luncheon without them. That is, while they're at the cemetery. And then number three, the family wants to thank you. Thank you for all the flowers that have been given in loving memory of Nellie. The family requests that if you gave a flower or a plant to the family, that they would like to request that you take it home and enjoy it in the memory, the loving memory of Nellie. And on behalf of the family, we want to thank you for your presence here today. We want to thank you for expressions of sympathy, care, and compassion, your prayers, your gifts, the flowers, of course, and all that you've done for them during this difficult time. They truly, truly appreciate it. We begin this service in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The service is printed out for you. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen. And let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come to you in an hour of great need. We are unable to heal the wounds of these our friends, who mourn the death of their dear loved one, Nellie. In your grace and mercy, comfort and sustain them. Our minds are confused, our hearts are heavy. Yet we know that you understand and your love has no limit. Help us all to fix our eyes upon Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. When sorrows overwhelm us, help us to know that you are the resurrection and the life. Grant each one the grace to believe in you and your precious promises. Let each one know that you will never leave us nor forsake us. And may you use these moments to prepare our own hearts to acknowledge you and know your tender mercies. For we pray this in the name of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Reading of the obituary. Nellie Nelson was born on October 24, 1946 in Marshall, Morris, and Gertrude Nelson. Nellie was baptized and confirmed at St. Luke's Lutheran Church in Woodlake. She graduated from Woodlake High School in 1964, then attended business school in Mankato for 1 year. December 22, 1973, Larry was united in marriage to Karen Sherry at Blackhammer Lutheran Church in Spring Grove, Minnesota. They were blessed with one son, Justin. They lived in Woodlake for 1 year, then moved to the family farm south of Woodlake. They moved to Marshall in 2012. Larry was fortunate to farm with his dad for many years and now has enjoyed farming with Justin. He joined his brother-in-law, Chuck, in the seed business, which led him to many new friends and amazing trips. Nellie was actively involved in sports from early on and years after high school. Enjoyed basketball, baseball, fast pitch softball, bowling, and golfing. Nellie made friends easily and was known for his organizing fun outings and activities for them. Being a basketball enthusiast, he dedicated many years as the girls' assistant basketball coach for the Echo Woodlake Cougars, the Lakeview Lakers. He thoroughly enjoyed coaching all the players whose lives he touched over the years. One of his recent coaching highlights was the Lakeview Girls Basketball Alumni Game held last January. At such a great time seeing all the former players. Nellie always had a quick joke to tell, a big voice on the sideline, and an even bigger heart. The fruit of Larry's faith shows in the giving and kindness of himself to so many. He leaves many sweet memories to his wife of 47 years, Karen, and his son Justin, and daughter-in-law Andrea, and to his grandchildren Austin and Brielle, who were so very precious to him. He will be missed by his sister Karen and Chuck Fisher. Nellie died on Saturday, January 30th, 2021, at the Vera McKinnon Hospital in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. In addition to his parents, Larry was preceded in death by his nephew Jeff, father-in-law Albert, and brother-in-law Nathan. Lord gave, the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Two scripture readings were chosen by the family to share with you this day. The first is from the Epistle to Romans, chapter 8, verses 31 and 39. What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who could be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also with him graciously give us all things? Who shall bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? Christ Jesus is the one who died, more than that, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed is interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword? As it is written, for your sake, we are being killed all the day long. We are regarded as sheep to be slaughtered. Knowing all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers nor height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And then the gospel reading is from St. John's Gospel, chapter 14. Jesus said, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, where I am, you may be also. You know the way to where I'm going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
All the hymns were chosen by the family, especially for this occasion. The hymn of comfort is number 770, What a Friend We Have in Jesus.
Thank you.
friends in Christ, especially to you, Karen, Justin and Andrea, Austin and Briella, you, Karen and Chuck, dear family and friends of Nellie. This moment is not a tragic moment. It is certainly a tender moment, but not a tragic moment. It's a comfort to know that God brought him the faith and the promise of salvation in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And so this moment is a moment of God's grace. God's love, care, and peace are here in his gospel promise of salvation. And throughout his life, Nellie experienced the Lord's tender care and love, his guidance, and his protection. He was baptized in the name of our great God and Father, Son, and Holy Spirit on November 17, 1946. On April 10, 1960, he publicly confessed his Christian faith in Jesus Christ. He was confirmed. His confirmation verse was Psalm 27, verse 4. It reads this: "One thing have I asked of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze upon the beauty of the Lord, and to inquire in his temple." And that he in which he sought after has come true, that he will be in the house of the Lord forever and ever. He was married to Karen on December 22nd, 1973, to have and to hold, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, the loved and cherished, till death do us part. He was a loving and faithful husband, 47 years of sweet memories and many adventures. Their marriage was blessed with one son, Justin. There were life lessons that Dad passed down to you from one generation to the next. And Justin said that his dad was a great example of good faith. There were joys and their sorrows, but God was good to Nellie. Nellie was fortunate to work side by side with his father on the family farm earlier in his life and then later in his life with his brother-in-law, Chuck, in the seed business. And I could tell that you had a great time together. And later on, Justin started farming. He had the great joy and privilege of helping him out. And Nellie loved his grandchildren. They were very precious to him. And I could tell he was precious to them. I asked Austin and Briella yesterday what they were going to miss about their grandpa. Remember that? They said that they were going to miss him playing the piano and all of the fun that they had with him. Oh. They didn't say that. That's a piano. Okay. But he didn't actually play the piano. That's a sweet memory, though, isn't it? Yeah. Of course, the gathering last night and the gathering here today, he was a man who was well respected in the community. Certainly beloved by many. He enjoyed a good many of friends. And he was kind, and he was warm-hearted. He was dedicated to this community and many others. And he enjoyed his time as a basketball coach for 13 years, I believe, right? He was a positive influence upon young people's lives, and through his dedication to the teams that he coached, he was always there with an encouraging word, instilling belief and a drive to succeed. An old hymn says this: "O victory in Jesus, my Savior forever, he sought me and bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me ere I knew him, and all my love is due him. He plunged me to victory." Lord Jesus Christ called Nellie home on January 30th, 2021, after dealing with a short battle. But He died in the Christian faith and is now enjoying the victory that is in Jesus by God's grace. The Lord bless his memory. He will be dearly, dearly missed. But in this hour of sorrow, can we say that God has been good to me? You see, grief is not a one-car train. It does not quickly pass. It takes time. We must be patient with ourselves and with others who grieve, who mourn the death of Nellie. The tears, the heartache, well, they show how much we care and that we love. So I ask you to wait upon our Savior Jesus, to trust in him. We can be confident of knowing that he will provide his comfort and his peace, and he promises that he will never leave us nor forsake us, even in times of darkness. Psalm 23, verse 4 says, "Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me." Psalm 23 has provided comfort and consolation, help and hope to God's people for thousands of years. It describes our Lord as a shepherd who in mercy tends, protects, guides, and leads, and feeds his sheep throughout their whole entire lives. It calls God's people to faith and trust in the Lord, knowing that he will provide even in the hour of deepest need, that he will not forsake us in times of darkness and in death. We know this because our Heavenly Father gave us his very own Son, Jesus Christ. He declares, "I am the Good Shepherd." The Good Shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The Lord Jesus Christ, who came to this sinful, broken world and to be our one and only Savior from sin and death, he lays down his life, that as he bores the sin of the whole world, including Nellie's sins, your sins, and mine. And he died a cruel death on that old rugged cross, taking the punishment that we deserved. And he laid down his life in order to take it up again. He rose from the dead on the third day, overcoming sin and death and winning the victory in Jesus, providing the victory that we now stand in. And God's grace is that unmerited favor of God. It is God's disposition towards us because of Christ's saving work upon the cross, his life, his death, and his resurrection. And in Christ Jesus, God, our Heavenly Father, offers the forgiveness of all our sins and peace and assurance of a place in heaven, the great hope of the resurrection unto everlasting life. Jesus said in our gospel reading, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. My Father's house are many rooms. And if it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also." So Jesus goes to prepare a place for all who die in the Christian faith to live in his presence and enjoy his fellowship for eternity. This is not some pie in the sky illusion, but it is a confession of faith. "Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever." God's people not only know his blessings in their life, but will live with him in heaven forever. And all who trust in Jesus Christ as Savior are confident that they will reach their eternal home to enjoy the love and joy of fellowship with God, because God has been so good to us. In the midst of sorrow, then, we also have the confidence of knowing that Nellie is enjoying that heavenly dwelling place as well, to dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Not because of what he did in his life, because of what the Lord Jesus Christ had did for him. Ephesians chapter 2, verses 8 and 9 say, "For by grace you have been saved through faith. This is not your doing, it is the gift of God, not as the result of works, so that no one may boast." And so today we commend Nellie to the Lord's care, the Savior, the Shepherd. His care is not just for all the days of our lives, but it's also for an eternity. And now Nellie rests safely in Jesus' arms. These last days of Nellie's life have been very difficult. Yet it could be said that neither death nor life will be able to separate us from the love of God that's found in Christ Jesus, our Lord. And God's love in Christ Jesus is more powerful than death. At the end of time, God will raise Nellie from the dead, and he will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. We look forward to that last great day, when Christ's victory over sin and death is fully known, that there will be a tremendous, joyful reunion. We don't know what our future holds us, the troubles, the joys, or even how long we will be here. But there's one thing that we can be certain of. We have a Savior who loves us and who holds our very lives in his hands and deals with us with such love and such care. And so I ask you, friend, do you trust Jesus as your Lord and your Savior? In our hour of need, when death causes us pain and grief, we have a Savior and a Shepherd who is ready to comfort us and to calm our fears, to console us. So let us believe in our hearts that our Lord is our loving Shepherd and our gracious Savior. And he has done everything for our eternal life and salvation. So let us be comforted by his tender love and care, because the Lord is my Shepherd, I shall not want. And surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. In Jesus' precious name, amen. Now the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep our hearts and our minds in Christ Jesus, unto life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come to you in an hour of great need. And amid our tears, O Lord, we praise you. We give you thanks that you have received Larry, Nellie, Alden, Nelson to yourself in glory for all eternity. We thank you that you brought him to the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. We commend to your gracious care in keeping these our friends. Grant them grace to say with a believing heart, your will be done. And know that your will is a good and gracious will, even now. We pray, comfort Karin, Justin and Andrea, Austin and Briella, Aaron and Chuck, the entire family, and all who mourn your gospel, which promises strength and help to the troubled and weary. O Lord, be with them. And prepare us for your word and spirit for that day when you will call us to yourself, that we might joyfully join the whole company of heaven to live with you forever and ever. For Jesus' sake we ask it. Amen. Behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised imperishable. We shall be changed. For this perishable body must put on the imperishable. This mortal body must put on immortality. When the perishable puts on the imperishable, and the mortal puts on immortality, then shall come to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your victory? O death, where is your sting? The sting of death is sin. The power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. For as much as it has pleased Almighty God in his wise providence to take out of this world the soul of our dearly departed brother in the Christian faith, Larry Holden Nelson, we therefore commit his body to the ground. Out of dust are you taken, unto dust you shall return, out of the dust you shall rise again. And may God the Father who created this body, may God the Son who by his blood has redeemed this body together with his soul, may God the Holy Spirit who by holy baptism has sanctified this body to be his temple, keep these remains until the day of the resurrection of all flesh. Amen. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who according to his abundant mercy has begotten us again to a living hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, who by reason of sin have caused man to die, return to the dust, so teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Grant us a true faith in your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, who delivered for our offenses, was raised again for our justification, and lived to all eternity. Help us by your grace that we may die daily unto sin, and may live according to your holy will, that when the hour of our death shall come, we may be fully prepared to depart in peace. Receive our soul unto yourself, and on the last day, raise our bodies from the grave unto life everlasting. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And Lord, remember us in your kingdom, and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Receive the benediction, the blessing of our Lord. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you, gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen. Our closing hymn is How Great Thou Art.